Airtable is an incredible software, but guaranteed there are some limitations that you are going to come up against if you continue to use it for any amount of time. In this video, I'm going to break down the three of the most common limitations within Airtable, but most importantly, tell you how to overcome them. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate your business and life, saving you up to 20 hours a week with no code tools. If you want to start reclaiming some of your time, the best place to start is by learning how to do no code automation. And I've put together a free training to help you do exactly that. You can check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I'll include links below this video. But without further ado, let's hop into the three biggest limitations of Airtable. Number one, we have got to talk about record counts, the number of records that you can store inside of an Airtable base or database. Now, I know that there's some talk currently about these record limitations possibly getting raised a little bit. I've been hearing this chatter for month over month, but I don't want to spread any rumors, so I'm gonna take you directly to Airtable pricing, and this is the best place for you to find the most up-to-date information about what Airtable record limitations are. On my screen, you see that there are four different packages or pricing tiers: Free, Plus, Pro, and Enterprise. And the biggest selling point, in my opinion, between these different tiers is going to be the number of records that you get when you upgrade to the next tier over. So yes, you can start using Airtable for free and you're getting those 1,200 records per month, but if you want to start storing any real information in there, you're probably going to need to be on that Pro plan or that Enterprise plan. And this is where you're getting 50,000 records per base on the Pro plan or 250,000 records per base on the Enterprise plan. Now, I also want to point out that this is per database, and a database is comprised of multiple tables that are all interlinked inside of that base. So we also have to be conscious of the limitation of records per table. This didn't used to be its own line item, but now that we have more records available on those enterprise plans at 250, well then we also have to be conscious of how many records we're able to get in one table. So while you can have 250,000 records in a database at the enterprise level, do notice that you only get 100,000 records per table, which essentially means that you would need a minimum of three tables in order to eclipse that 250,000. But now for the good news. How do you overcome this limitation? There are plenty of our clients who are not quite at that enterprise level. They don't have the enterprise need, but they do get a lot of value out of Airtable, and they have eclipsed the 50,000 record mark. So how did we make this work? Well, yes, they are on a Pro plan, but what we have to make sure that we're doing is that we are reducing or weeding out the extra information in a database. Now, this doesn't mean that you have to delete it completely, because the other thing to note is that you get an unlimited number of bases in your Airtable workspace. So you can have a workspace that has 40 different databases, and each one of those databases has its own unique record limitation. Meaning if you have 40 databases, each one of them can hold 50,000 records in its own right. So how does this come in handy? Well, if you have a database that you work with day in, day out, let's take this example here. I've got contacts and projects. Not a whole lot of information in here, but let's imagine that I wanted to make sure that I wasn't gonna hit that record limitation. Well, it's time for me to archive the data that I have in this database so that I can continue to use it. Pretty simple and straightforward process. Inside the database itself, come up to the top, and where you have the three dots here, you can ask to duplicate the base. Now, in doing so, you're gonna get a prompt. Where do you wanna put the duplicate copy of the base? What workspace is it gonna go to? You can always move this later. Also, do you wanna duplicate the records? And then lastly, do you wanna duplicate the comments? Now, if you're archiving data, the answer to those second two questions should be yes. Yes, you want to duplicate the records. Yes, you want to duplicate the comments. Let's go ahead and duplicate that base. And what we're going to see is a base with the exact same style as the previous one. Airtable Example now has a duplicate copy called Airtable Example Copy. I can pop into this and simply rename this with my archive, right? So I can say archived on May 29th, 2022. Now, you'll notice that all the information that I had in my previous database is here. So I've got my same contacts, I have my same projects, all my views have been duplicated, all of my records, etc. This is really helpful because I don't have to go through some copying and pasting of all the different information inside of my Airtable base. Now for the second part of this, again, imagining that I had a limitation on my first base, I can go back to my first base and start deleting. I can select all my projects here and then right click and delete all my records, thereby removing all of the records I have in a particular table, and I can start over from scratch. Now, why do we want to do it this way? Well, imagine that we have a lot of automations that are looking at our primary database. We want to make sure to archive the information in a separate database so that we don't break any of the automations that are working with our primary database. So remember, always create a copy, archive it into a separate database, and then go back into your original database that you work with day in, day out, and weed out a lot of those extra records so that you don't butt up against the record limitation. Limitation number two that I guarantee you're going to come up against at some point is when you share access of your Airtable database with anyone else, you are giving them full-blown access to your entire base. So what does this mean? Well, if you have some clients that you're working with and you want to share some information with them, but you don't want them to see everything, or maybe you have an intern on your team who you want to share some things with, but not everything in the company, well, you're out of luck, friends, because Airtable, when you share it, it's going to give full-blown access. Now, this comes with an asterisk because it is possible for you to share access to a read-only view. And this is perfect if you want an external shareholder, someone outside of your organization, to see what's in your database in one particular section. But the caveat here is that they can't actually do anything with it. So in order to share a view, if I wanted to share my projects, for example, I could simply click on Share View, create a shareable grid view link, and this link right here I can share with anyone I'd like to, and they're going to have read-only access to whatever information is presently in that view. So if I copy and paste this, bring it into another browser, this is exactly what anyone else would see who uses this same view. Again, they can't make any changes here, they can't edit anything, it is read-only. And here's the reason why this is often inefficient is because when you're sharing access to a view, you want the person who has that access to be able to do something with it. So there are two key workarounds for this. In option one, you can create a button inside of this view. In the shared read-only view, you can have a button that anyone who has that read-only access can push that button. They can make some changes, and then a fancy automation on the background can pick up whatever changes they submit in a form and update the live data that you have in your database. Now, this workaround is definitely involved, and I've created a video specific to this particular workaround. I will be sure to link to that below, so check that out if you're interested. The benefit of using this is that it doesn't require any third-party tools, and you can use all of the things that are natively within Airtable itself to create this slight workaround or hack that allows somebody to make some edits in a kind of roundabout way. My preferred method, though, is to use a third-party tool called Softr. If you haven't heard of Softr, it is, in my opinion, the leading front end for Airtable. A front end allows you to build an interface that interacts with your data that lives in Airtable, but every user can be logged in through Softr. They'll have their own login to your specific app that you can control. It allows you to determine exactly what they're going to see. Everything they see, everything they edit, everything that they're allowed to touch is controlled by you when you build the app. Now, this is a bit more of an involved scenario. Obviously, it requires that you build this thing in Softr, and it requires that you also have a bit more of a budget because Softr is a third-party tool to Airtable, and it's going to come with its own cost. That being said, it definitely gives you the most control over how people will interact with your data. So if you need to tweak how people see or what they interact with inside of your Airtable database, this is an option you should consider. Now, the third big limitation that comes with using Airtable has to do with Airtable Automations. Airtable Automations allows you to perform a lot of automated processes, But it's a very limited amount of automation that you can actually perform. It might seem amazing to a beginner, but as you dip into automation more and more, you'll start to have more advanced use cases that the Airtable automation just doesn't hack. Now, I don't mean for this to sound like a slam, because at the end of the day, Airtable is not an automation tool. First and foremost, Airtable is a relational database, and they knock it out of the park. That being said, when it comes time for automation, it's really nice that they give us some automation potential, but for the more advanced automations, it's very common that we need to again go to a third-party tool. So let's look at an example of an automation that you cannot do in Airtable that you can easily put together in a third-party tool. Inside of Airtable automations here, the trigger doesn't matter. I've just simply said, I'm going to trigger this automation at one time. And let's imagine that what I want to do is look at all of my projects. So here in my action step, I've said, find all of the records in my projects table that meet a condition, namely the condition where the status is equal to in progress. So let's really quickly pause here, go back to our projects, and we see that we have two projects that are in progress for the status. We have project one for Frodo Baggins, project two for Legolas. So back in our automation now, inside of here, if we were to test this find function, we will see that it does exactly what we would hope. We test the action and it says, hey, I found two projects, project one with Frodo, project two with Legolas. What do you want me to do with it? Here's where Airtable Automations has one of its key limitations. If I want to go into these projects and update the status for both of them and make them complete, for example, I can't do it. There's no way for me to iterate inside of Airtable Automations. I can't say go one by one unless perhaps I write a really fancy script. But this is no code, and my preference is to avoid any kind of coding at any point in time unless it's absolutely necessary. This is why I love third-party automation tools. Make has quickly become my automation tool of choice. I've also used Zapier extensively. These are third-party tools that interact with our data in Airtable and can perform more advanced automations. Let's take a look at Make and look at how simple it is to set up this automation. Here I've built a search records function. I'm saying the exact same thing as I did before. Look at my projects table in my example database here. And I want to find all records that match this condition. The condition is status equals in progress. Now, don't let this syntax worry you. The reason that I have status in squiggly brackets is because status is the name of my field in Airtable. And in progress is text in this case, so I need to surround it by either single or double quotes. But it's simply saying I'm looking for all the projects that have a status equal to in progress. And here's where you can set your limitation. How many do you want to bring back? I have this at a limitation of 10, but you can crank this up to whatever you'd like. Now, once you're good here, let's go ahead and look at what Make allows us to do has this iterator function. We get this by dropping into our tools here at the bottom and just plugging in an iterator. Because if we were to just run this first module by itself, let's run it, we know that there are two projects. Project one and project two. Now we only get a single output here, but if we dial into that, we see that in fact there are two different bundles that it's identified, project two and project one, which is exactly what we would have expected. Now in order to perform the next step of updating the status to be complete for both of these projects, we need to first perform that iterator. The iterator is where we say, I want to break up all these projects and do them one at a time. So take that record ID that you got from the output of the previous step and break it up, and we're gonna do whatever comes after the iterator, we're gonna do it for every single one of those things that we identified back here. Really easy to set up. Now I'm just gonna update the record. What record? Well, of course, it's in the projects table. The value, the record ID that I am updating is whatever got spat out of the iterator in the previous step. And all I want to do is update the status here to completed. It's that simple. So let's go ahead and run this. But before we do, let's first flip back to Airtable and take a look at our current projects. We have those two projects that are in progress, project one and project two, and we've built an automation to update them to completed. So if I go back to make and I select run once, I can then flip back to Airtable just in time to see that those statuses were updated to completed. So yes, we are able to build a more advanced automation, but we have to go outside of the Airtable automation environment. I want to reiterate that in no way do I mean this to be a slam against Airtable. Every single software out there has its own limitations. Airtable's an incredible tool. The point of this video is not to put down Airtable, but to help you find workarounds to three of the most common limitations in Airtable. I hope you got a ton of value out of it, and if you did and you want to stay on top of no code and no code news, be sure to subscribe to this channel, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.